Hello everyone, this is Roman. I want to show you today one great update I made for the Nitrobox tool. I want to show you actually the news, and also I fixed a lot of stuff and I want to show you how it's working now. So let's begin and show you. Okay, so I want to show you just a simple stuff. So I just make something simple here, okay? Okay, so the first fix is, now if I go here and I move, you can see everything is moving because the axis is not enabled. Before, it's always enabled. So when enabled now, you can see now the axis is don't take the tindre. So like this, you can enable disable. So this is the first. If I go now here, for example, in this here, in the object, and I've moved, you can see now the pattern is moving, the tindre is moving. You can see how cool. And also if I make, for example, the scale, you can see, and like this, you can easy, for example, change your shape without need to make a lot of change if you want. For example, you're going down, it's going down. So like this, so great. Another update is if I go here and I make, for example, a curve, okay, like this. Let's go here and make also here a curve, just have a little bit this. Now there is a font tag. You can change the font if you want. Also, you can control the font. So this is just another update. And another update is if you go with the bevel tool now, there is also the yellow point. So like this, you can simply change the flatten radius and also the subdivision radius, and also you can go here, for example, and you can make something like this. You can see just simply you can enable this tool. So like this, you change also the bevel you want, very simple. Just now I add in the dev, you go in the yellow point, you can change also the radius of flatten and the sub. Another great update is the inner tool. Now there is inner tool. You can go highlight where you like. You can see. You can see this orange. And now if I click and hold, you can see I make actually inner. I can make inside or outside. I can do as many times I want. You can see how cool and easy. And also you can make material if you want. For example, let's make a red material here. Okay. And I can go here, for example. I can make inner just like this. You can see how simple. And also, if you want, you can control, for example, if I go here, you can control the dev. You can see, you can make it on, the scale, you can see. And also, you can control, if you want, the flat radius easy, like this. And when you're done, you can go here. Another tip I want to tell you is, if I go now in there, and I make, for example, up, because this is a spline, you can go after that and make the select all the points, and you can make chamfer. You can see you can make chamfer just like this to have a better. But you need to select points. For example, this one. Because it's already this chamfer, and like this, you can see now I'm making chamfer like this. And now I can go. Actually, I can go back, and now I can control. I make it in. I can control this. You can see. And also, if I want, I can change point, you can move the point if I want. You can see how cool. So this is another great update for the init tool. That's another small stuff. When you make, for example, here in the spline, you can see now, you can see the dev. This is just a fix, a small fix. And now let's show you the rest. So let's make a new skin here. Let's make here a blue, a yellow, and green, because I want to show you the history. The history now is very great. I want to show you how it's working. Actually, I make something with the green. Okay, actually, I want to make with the rectangle here. Okay, just I make the green here and make something like this. Okay, and I go here. Okay, now I make enable the history here. And now let's make some here rest stuff. You can see now I make rest stuff. Okay. Maybe I make another one here. Let's make, actually, I make one mistake. Don't forget to enable and disable this. But okay, because this is create a lot of history, you can see now. But it's okay, don't worry. Just now I make a new with the blue. Okay. And now I just disable. So like this, I work into this history part. You can see now I work into this here. So I fix the problem about enable and disable. You can see now everything is working nice here. Okay, you can see here. You can enable and disable the history. And the nice thing now is And now it's working this great because now if I go, for example, to the red here, I can make here also, you can see very simply, or I go here, you can see, very nice. But now there is a new option. This is now is put in the panel in the top. So this is make a new. So like this, you don't touch your preview histories, for example. If you go, if you like also to go here in the begin, you can uncheck this. And now, if I take the green, for example, and I make some here, you can see now the spline is going here. You can see now I'm in here. If I go now to the blue, you can see it's going here. So like this now, it's fine automatic where is the history pattern. And he's put the spline. So like this is working, you can see it's very great. Now, let's show you the rest. Actually, like this is working. Where you have an empty the top pattern, is going to the top. You can see everything I do is going to the here. But if I make uncheck, it's going where automatic find where is the pattern. For example, the red pattern, you can see is going to this here. So actually in this here, you can see in the red. And like this, you can easy select what you like. Also the nice thing other is if I go here and I select, for example, let's say this, and I hover control and I check the top pattern, automatically is change the pattern. You can see, very nice. It's going here, I click here, it's going here. If I go to the red, for example, it's going here, you can see, very nice. But if I make it top, it's always going to the top. You can see it's always going to the top, like this. So now the history is working great. You can see. So now make sure you disable the history. And let's show you a tip. So let's make some, just a simple here object. Let's go here and make a green and just make something like this. And now let's give curve, okay. And now let's go here, make no tags, and let's give solid. Let's give a little bevel. Now, if I want to make something solid, you see now if I make like this, you see it doesn't work because actually the solid is new, it's going down. But if you want to make a work, you can simply enable the history just one time. And for example, do your stuff here, you disable it. And now, actually, this you can see very nice, you can work solid. You can do here now also in solid. Because this actually is one mess. You see how cool? Okay, so this is just a tip, just to know how you can make changes the solid if you want. And now, finally, I'm going to show you the great thing. So now there is an object here, you can see. So let's make just a new here, just something new here. Let's actually make something. Give a little bit, just I make something interesting here to see. Okay, maybe red here, okay. Okay, give a little bit bevel here also, and also give bevel in the corners like this, nice. Okay, let's make a copy here, this one, something like this, let's say. And now, let's go here and enable also no tags here, solid. Okay, just to give the solid to everyone here, you can see. And now there is a new command here that to mesh, NitroBox mesh. So this actually helps you to have a quick object. You can see here. If I want to make this, you can see I have my solid here, very nice. Also, you want to do the center, you need to enable it in the center here. And now you can see the solid center. So like this, you can make an image you want, for example, or you can do like you want this object. This is also the gray command is working also, for example, let's go here. Let's make something new here. Okay. Actually, this I want to do is I want to go here and I make a tag enable. Let's go here, just enable the bevel here. And also here, okay. But I don't go here. Okay. So now check this out. If I go here in the object and I make this here now, it's return a mess. And the great thing now, this is a polygon. So now, for example, I can go, for example, here to change the points if I want. You can see very easy. I can change points. I can change edge if I want. For example, okay, not like this. Can change like this, for example, if you want. You can see how cool. And now like this you can change easy. So this also is working for the shape. And also you can select a lot of objects here and you can make here, you can see, now it's everything mess. So now with this you can make some change one. Okay, for example, let's go here, select the points, scale, you can see, just like this, simply, nice. So this is also the new command, how simply you want to use. This is working to any here, any Nitrobox, rectangle, cyclic, also spline, if you want. And if you go to the Nitrobox box generator and you click, it's written the final mesh here. And also it's have a nice clear color here. Okay. Okay, so the next I want to show you now is I want to show you if you have the R2N, you can use the volume. And now I want to show you how it's working this. I'm still working on this. Right now it's have little bit update problems, but it's working. But to make it work, you need to do like this. First, you need to make a connect and check the width. Next, you go to the volume here, beetle, and last, go to the volume mesh. And now you can go here, you can make the change. You can see how nice. Now you can change in the volume. You can see how cool. You can see, for example, it's have some small stuff. I don't know why this happened. I try to fix. For example, when I go create a new, you can see just 1 second, you see these splines. Okay. You can see how nice and cool now you can do with the volume stuff. Okay, very cool. How cool. I go here, for example, and change the voxels. Like this, you can make you can get a quad mesh. So yep, this is about the new update. I hope you like and find it useful this update. This update I sent already to everyone, and also I released my site. I'm working also to the next update of this plugin. I make some more nice, great tools stuff. I release the next days also. So thank you for watching this video, and more plugins coming soon.